Hello and welcome to the Creating Room. My name is Brooke Shaden and I'm a fine art photographer. And we're looking at an image today that has been requested by a few people. And I thought it would be really fun to go through this particular picture because it was a lot of building from the ground up, a lot of weird stuff happening here, and a lot of it out of necessity. When you don't have a lot of resources to shoot with or create with, then you get creative. So let's take a look at this image. It's a lot of layers and a lot of different types of manipulation here. So let's go ahead and just start at the bottom and see if we can work our way through. Now, I shot this image in a forest, but in a particular area where there were a lot of people, a lot of foot traffic coming through a road right next to us. And I also just happened to have a film crew with me on that particular day. And so we were trying to, keep it light, not hike super far into the forest. We all had to have easy parking. So this was kind of what I got. And I found this little platform where I knew that I could pose unobstructed, meaning that my feet wouldn't dig into the ground. The background was still really foresty, nature-y, so that could work. And so I just chose this location. It wasn't super well thought out, but it was what I had to work with at the time. And so that's what I did. So I started to build from here, using this as my backdrop and changing it drastically. So let's see, if we go up here, we can see this tree start to pop in. And this tree was from a really, like, just right around the corner from where we were. I photographed it, knowing the angle that I needed to get, and then started to find other elements to add in. So I had the tree, I had the roots, and these were really important for changing the space. I mean, the roots alone make such a difference, and it just extends the look of the natural forest floor rather than concrete. It's not in me to create something really modern, and I love creating images that are timeless, so having a concrete slab to stand on was not gonna cut it. So I added in the roots, which created a great flow as well from the tree to me, so we're sort of connected in this really interesting way. And I continued to do that by finding more roots, more tree, adding that on. These are even two different types of trees that I've blended together, and so on and so forth. And so these elements are just all different trees. Now if we go down, I'll make sure that we have the right shading and things like that. This is a very funny step where I'm changing the color of the dress, and that will get refined as well coming up. All right, so these are just little color changes. We've got our fog in. Now I put this fog in not knowing if I was going to keep it or not, because I didn't love this location. It's a hodgepodge of locations. It's really green. I don't love green. So I put that in, unsure of what we were going to do with that, but we'll see. This was definitely, I mean, look at this. We're not in a good place right now, right? Then I was definitely in a place of exploration at this point. I'm building and building and having no idea if it's gonna work, just trying my best. So let's see how this ends up, because eventually we gotta get somewhere, right? So we got the rope. I brought rope with me, photographed it there, did my best to make it look like it was tied around me and the trees. And there were a lot of different decisions that went into everything that you see here. So, for example, with this set that really changes the coloring, I realized that it wasn't really believable that it would be so bright blue. And so I started to desaturate, add more color back in that wasn't that really overpowering blue, more rope. And every single stage is just wondering what's going to look good next. Because this image did not look good for a really long time. I struggled against it for a while, just trying new things, seeing if the next thing would be good. I finally got to put in this little layer of smoke, and that really helped things for me. When I put that layer of smoke in, I started to feel like there was some atmosphere happening, and I actually liked that there was something in the background, and that led to a future choice that you'll see about adding some trees back into this picture, even though I originally took them away. And So we're going to get there. It needed to be, you see how dark it got? It was a bright picture and I really darkened it. Partially because I like to shoot underexposed and I hadn't done that here. It was quite a bright picture for me. But also because I don't feel like an image is mine unless there's some darkness to it. So I love to make it a little bit dark, but I often have to go brighter then because I take it a little too far. This vignette is quite a heavy vignette, and I actually really like it because it makes it feel more fairy tale to me. Whenever there's a really heavy, thin vignette around an image, I love that. Okay, so we're getting to the new forest up here really soon. There. That's the forest that I added in. Not the same forest that I had photographed there. This was a forest where you could see all the trees, lots and lots of space, and I thought that that worked best because it still made the foreground seem really removed from the rest of the forest, but there's something in the background, and I just thought it was a really nice touch, so I kept that. And then the rest of these changes are just the final color, darkness, light, contrast, saturation, and all of that. And there was a lot to do here. I spent a lot of time really highlighting the tree, bringing out the highlights and the contrast and the detail, making sure that there are many points of interest, because if we, let's zoom out, this is a really simple image when you look at it. Just one person, really pulled back, lots of negative space. I wanted there to be visual interest everywhere to make it worth it to have this big of a frame, and also so that there was something visually arresting about this image to make people stop and look at it, which is so important. It's not just composition or just color or just light. It's so many different things that make someone stop and look at it, not least of which is the concept. This was a really great concept for me. I love the idea of being tied down but breaking free. That's one of my favorite things to explore. So I use the rope here to portray that, but I also am deeply in love with forests and trees and our connection to that. And this is almost like humanity pulling away from that natural connection to the earth. So that's the image. It's called Tethered. And I know that some of you guys wanted to see how this was put together, so I hope that that shed some insight into that, and I hope that you go out there and make something amazing, beautiful, and connected this week. See you next time!